Time so you can see how this works and how I think. Okay, so here we go. Okay, that's a 5. That's a 4-1. Okay, 6-4-2. Heart 8. Six, one, seven. That's okay. Leave it alone. Five, 41. And another 5, 41. All right, let's take a look at these here, the way what we did. Let me just set them up and kind of give you an idea here of how I think and what we did here. And we'll roll another 6 numbers or so here in a minute. But the first one was a 5, okay? And by the way, I work on my come out rolls, okay? So normally I'm always working. All right, so we hit a 5 here, okay? So we won on our 5, so that's one win. Then, and it's also part of the hop system, which we won here. So that would be 2 wins we won, okay, on this 5. Then we threw a 6. We won here on our 6, okay? Nothing on, nothing on the hop. Then we threw an 8. We got paid on our 8 here. Then we threw a 6-1. Which would have gave us a win at level 3 on our hops. Then back to the 5 again here and here. So we won 2 there. And another 5 again here and here. So on the 6 rolls, we won twice here, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, 6, 7, 8. We won 9 times in those 6 rolls. That's what I call the power of multiple wins. Okay, so now let's set it up again, and we'll redo it just to give you an idea. Let me just shoot all over again. Okay, let's do it again, and this time we're going to include the field with it. All right, here we go. Okay, 5, another 5. Obviously, it looks like 5 would be my 6. Whoops, sorry about that. That was a 4-1. Obviously, it looks like a 5 would be my signature number. Okay, and we got a 9. Beautiful. I love 9s. 63. Roll number 3 here, the second set. 12. Beautiful. Good thing we included the field. That was a triple. Okay, a couple more rolls. Heart 8. Three, 21. Whoops, that's a 1. Sorry about that. That was like that. And a 42, a 6. Okay, now let's kind of look at this here, see what we got. All right. We have another 5, so we got paid here, and we got paid here on our 4-1. Okay, so that's another 2 wins. added to our previous ones. Now we got a 6-3. Let me show you the 6-3. We got paid here on the 9. We got paid here in the field. And we got paid here on the hop. This is a great example of the power of multiple wins. So we got paid another 3 wins on that. Okay? Then we got the 12, which we have a $10 field. We're getting paid on that triple. Okay? So that's in essence like 3 more wins. So we put the 3 wins here. And then we have a hard 8, which we get paid on our 8. That's another win. Okay, then we got paid on our 3 in the field over here. That's one more win. And then we threw a 6, which we got paid here on our 6. So that's another win. All right, so based on this right here, on 12 rolls, we got 20 wins, 20 total wins. Now, the way it ended up, we would be at level, let's see, we want our hop here, 1, 2, 3, 4. We could realistically have to go up a little bit on our hop bet to level 5, not a problem. We won the field here, so we'd be maybe at level 2 unless we were including it with our base bets. So, but that pretty much will give you an indication of what you can do with this. We threw the dice 12 times and we won 20, okay? So there's our 20 wins. If that average win was $10, you're on track for your 1,000 a week. And we did that in 5 minutes, 10 minutes. Okay? So you think about that. Action. So as you can see, you have a lot of options. Then once you get in the zone, you're going to see your play, you're going to make your bet, and you're going to collect your money. When I play, I shoot for 40 to 50 wins per hour when I play by myself. So basically, there you go. That's how you earn $1,000 a week with Advantage Dice Control, and it's not hard to do. How do you get into the game? Okay, first off, when I park my car, I already have my game plan. I have my bankroll in my pocket. I know exactly the methods I'm going to play. It's pretty much the same all the time now. Okay, and I know my win goal. I'm going to be there for approximately an hour, and I'm going to hit my 40 to 50 wins. So now I'm the predator. I walk up to the table with confidence. I'm going to buy in. I normally buy in with $1,000. That's just the way I do it. You don't have to start with that, okay? And I make my bets. So I make a pass line bet, obviously, which gives me the right to shoot. That is the only reason I make that pass line bet. I also start tipping the dealers right away. So I'll place a $4 horn here, and I'll place a yo bet, a dollar yo, for the dealer, okay? Understand something here. A lot of you guys might think that I'm making the horn bet to offset or to hedge my pass line bet, which is not the case. I'm making two separate bets here. This one gives me the right to shoot, but that one's there for a particular reason because we throw a shitload of them, all right? So that's why we do that one. That's part of our hop system, okay? That I'll explain to you a little bit further down here, okay? So I'll throw the dealer. Let's just say I'm playing the 4 through 10. For 64 cross, and I'll throw them another $7 to start my hop bets. This might be one way that I play, and it normally is how I play. The only thing that might change is I'll start with higher increments or maybe play a different hop, which again I'll show you here in a little bit down the road. Okay. Now the dealers will pay attention to me. Okay. They know I'm here to play. I start tipping them right away. Okay. I don't want any delays. I want the dice right back. I don't let them pause my game or stall my game at all, even if I'm the only one there. Even if I'm the only one there, I'll use my hand motions like this. Come on, give me the dice. All right, come on, give me the dice. Actually, let me tell you a story. I do that, and because I'm there so early, they think I have to go to work. So I'll say, come on, let's go. I got to get to work, guys. Hurry up. And that kind of keeps them in check. Plus the fact that I'm tipping them always with what's called gimme money. So for example, I'll throw a dollar on the horn. If I hit a number here, I'm going to win $14. So I might place $4 on the hard ways for them or something like that. Oh, I also got a field bet too. This is how I play. Okay, forgot that. Sorry about that. All right, so now the dealers will pay attention to me. I get the dice right back, and I continue tipping them throughout my roll. Okay, all right. So you got to have good posture, either stick right or stick left. At the beginning of the video, watch the way I shoot. Okay, I did both stick left and stick right, so you can kind of get an idea of my form there. So I look where I want to hit, where I want to land. And once I'm in the zone, I'm looking for my 40 or 50 wins in an hour, and I'm done. So when you hit your landing zone and you see what you want to see, we have certain things we look for. You simply just set them, grip them, and toss them the same identical way and repeat it. Get your money and you're done for the day. Okay? All right. Next question. How do I get out of the game? And that's a good question. Understand something. First of all, always remember, nobody watches your money better than you. Okay? Always know what your chip count is. Always know what you're getting paid. I catch mistakes every day. If I'm at the table with other players, I see mistakes all the time, and they don't even know it because everybody automatically thinks the dealer's right and they just pick up their chips, and that's not the case, okay? So I catch a lot of mistakes, especially when I'm using the super hop, okay? Because when you're using this hop bet here, the way we have it, okay, we have seven bets. I mean, the dealers don't see the shit we do. They don't understand it. A lot of people will make one hop bet. They'll say, give me a hard six on the hop, or give me a hard eight on the hop. But they don't make seven bets like we do, okay? They've never seen the stuff that we do. So sometimes when I have a bigger bet out here, let's say I got a $30 bet on each one or a $10 bet or whatever it is. I mean, they have to have a meeting to try and figure it out. I got to tell them what I'm getting paid on. It's kind of funny. So know your payouts, okay? Again, nobody watches your money better than you. It's your money, okay? So, all right. All right, so let's talk about getting out of the game here for a minute. I got my bets set up, and how you get out of the game, a couple of different ways. If I'm close to my goal, obviously I want to get out of the game, okay? So let's say I'm close to my goal and I want to get out of the game. Well, you're obviously always going to get out on a win, okay? So, for example, if I throw a four, okay? Well, I'm going to win on that four. I can now take all these bets down because this is a separate entity, all right? So they're all gone. Also, if I hit a four, I can take my field bet down. You know what? Let's just, doesn't matter what the point is. Let's just say the point's a five, okay? So I threw a four. I take this bet down and this bet down, okay? If it was a 2-2, all right? Let's say it was a 3-1. Now I can take them all down. This is already gone, okay? I can collect here, take this bet down, collect in the field here and take this bet down. And if it was a 3-1, I'm out of the game. Okay, so now I'm out. I can get out. And what I'll do at this point, especially if I'm still shooting the dice, which I would be, now I'll just keep my 6 and 8 up and then collect and press from there. Okay, so I'll take all this out, just go with a minimum on the 6 and 8, collect and press and see what I can do with it. Once I 7 out, I color up or go right to the cage or whatever I do, and I'm done for the day. Okay, so that's how you get out of the game. Another way you might want to get out of the game is, let's say I'm looking at my chip count and I'm short $100. I need $100 to make my 500 bucks, let's say, okay? And let's say I have, let's take these off here for a minute, just to talk. Let's say I have $30 each up here, okay? I have 120 inside, let's just say, okay? And I'm 100 short of my 500 goal. Okay, so I might say to myself, well, shit, all I got to do here is take $100 off of there, okay, because that's 120 inside, throw them $2 and play with 22 inside. Now I got my win goal for the day and I can realistically go. So now the same thing, I'll have 22 inside, and as I'm throwing, I'll collect and press, build it up again, who knows, maybe I'll make another $200, $300, $400, and then 7 out, I'm gone, whatever it is, okay. So that's how you get out of the game. Think about what I just said, too, because there's a lot of times you could have your daily goal by just regressing down what you've already got on the table, okay? And then you're done, all right? So a lot of people don't think of that. So think of that. It's a good little tip. Okay. I'm going to do this new set with the reinforced, what I call the reinforced grip here, with no spin, okay? I should throw some hard weights.
Six hard.
Wow.
So we weren't working on the come out.
What is that you're using? So you're at level one or two?
No, I haven't made the point. I wasn't working. Because if I was playing other shooters, I would not be working, but I would be here.
Eight hard.
Wow. That's good.
Okay. You're going to throw a lot of hard ways with this, you guys.
Ten.
Right, Kevin.
That was hard, too.
No, it was 6-4.
I was ready to go to the casino.
I want to make a bill like Jesus.
I was ready to leave, go to the casino.
Didn't have his glasses on. Eight.
Those are all good numbers.
Did you pay me on my eight?
12.
Did you pay me on that eight, I guess?
No.
Eight,
yes. How come?
Because everybody said everything was off. That's what I heard.
I'm fucking rolling for nothing?
You are.
All right, let's just roll then. Hell, let's just go.
Seems to be the case.
We're seeing where it's winning.
Well, I'd be having the hard ways covered.
Five.
Hard five.
Hard five. Hard nine, right here?
Hard nine, yeah.
I do that to the dealers sometimes. When I do. When I'm throwing the hard ways, if it's like a new dealer, I'll go, give me a hard nine, honey. To the sticker. And she's gone.
Yeah.
Five again. Press my five.
Okay.
No, I'm just talking.
Okay.
I'm just talking. Just talking.
There's three. Yes.
Oh, that sucked.
Four. Okay. Hard.
Hard four.
A lot of hard ways with this set, you guys, I'm telling you. But gimme money. It's all gimme money.
Two crap.
Two.
Another hard
Snake
way.
Yeah, hard
two. Another hard way. It's 30 to 1.
Eight.
Eight.
Good throw.
Eight again.
I go this fast when I'm playing by myself. I do not let them slow my game. But I'm tipping them too.
Okay.
Press the hard ways, high, dealer yo, or dealer hard eight.
Yeah.
So they're with me on everything, okay? So they watch, they pay me quick, they give me the dice quick. Most of the time they'll even give it to me with that set if they see what I'm throwing,
okay?
As a courtesy.
Three craps. Six hard.
I worked on this set for about 2 weeks before I decided, you know, I got to use this.
How'd you come up with it in the first place?
Hmm?
How'd you come up
with it in the first
place? Five.
Told you, press those fives, right?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Guess I pressed it again. Eight hard.
So you're doing 6-1 on top, and then the same on the five.
All hard ways, $100, please.
Six.
6-1, 2-2 facing.
Right here, Dave.
Yeah.
Okay.
But you're not throwing it with the... You're throwing it, keeping it from spinning, too.
Nine.
That's right. I'm not doing any spin at all. Only because when I did it the first, I threw the seven the first time. That's why I switched to this, right?
Mm-hmm.
Remember, we play with a purpose. All the time. We know our next move, okay?
Mm-hmm. Eight. Eleven. Ten hard.
Every time it sucks, you get a hard one.
Every time you say it, say, yeah, exactly. Every time you say it sucks, you
all right, it sucked again then.
You know, it looks bad, but.
Three craps.
Works out.
Yeah.
I tell you, with the way I've just been shooting right here, I'd have gone home already.
Yeah, you could have.
Six.
Point.
Don't worry about the points. I just keep rolling. Because I'm working, don't forget. So when I get a point, I'm working. It don't
matter. I'm just saying, now it's seven.
Seven out, okay, good.
Right, so well, that would roll.
Oh. Okay, any questions? We can be heroes everywhere we go. We can have all that we ever want.
Every spotlight, every soundbite, everybody who gave up is just a fuel for wanting him.